Welcome to Minute Maths. In this video we are going to go through practice GCSE style questions relating to collecting like terms and simplifying. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. For a refresher on this topic, see our video linked above and in the description below. Let's look at this first question. We are given four sub-questions to answer. These sorts of questions are usually worth one mark each. Question 1 asks us to simplify the expression b plus b plus b plus b. Here we have four lots of b's, which can also be written as 4b. This is now in its simplest form. The second question asks us to simplify a multiplied by itself four times. When we multiply a term by itself, we can use indices to show this in a simpler form. As we are multiplying a by itself four times, we can simply write a to the power of 4. For question 3, we are asked to simplify 7j plus 9j. These terms are the same, because the variables are both j, we can simply add these two terms together. We have 7 lots of j, plus 9 lots of j, so in total we have 16 lots of j. We can write this as 16j in its simplest form. Question 4 asks us to multiply 5t by 3r. Even though these are not like terms, as the variables t and r are different, we can still multiply these together. Firstly, multiply the coefficients together, giving us 15. Multiplying t by r means we have t lots of r, which can be written as tr. We therefore have 15 lots of tr. We have successfully simplified all of the expressions. Let's have a go at another set of questions. For question 1, notice there is a subtraction at the end of the expression. So we have 3 lots of g, minus 1g. This leaves us with 2g. The second question asks us to multiply 2 lots of c by 3. For this, we can simply multiply the coefficients together and make sure we include the c. Essentially, we have 3 lots of 2c, so we have 6c. For question 3, notice we have two different terms here, and because this involves addition, we cannot add two different terms together. So, we should collect the like terms and deal with them individually. We can collect 3b and b together, adding them gives us 4b. Then we can collect the n terms together, including the signs, giving us 5 lots of n. This expression is now in its simplest form. The fourth question asks us to add two terms together. However, these terms are not like terms and therefore can't be added together. So, this expression is already in its simplest form. These next set of questions are slightly trickier. Be mindful of the first question, as there is a subtraction. As all the terms are the same, we can simply add the first two terms and subtract the last. In the second question, there are three different types of terms, y, z, and yz. Let's gather the like terms and simplify any that we can. Now all the terms that are remaining are different, we cannot add or subtract terms that are not like terms, therefore this expression is now in its simplest form. For the third question, we are asked to add up 3 lots of h squared. The term h squared will remain the same. Therefore, we have 3h squared. Finally, question 4 contains two different types of terms. D and d squared. Although both of these contain the variable d, they are not classed as like terms as they have different powers. So we cannot add or subtract a term in d to a term in d squared. To simplify this, we can collect the like terms. Thanks for watching. Check out some of our other GCSE practice question videos on our channel.